We begin with a question whispered into history. Can machines think? A question that didn't aim to build a machine, but to test the boundaries of humanity itself. Alan Turing stood before the unknown, not seeking fame, but clarity. He believed intelligence was not magic, it was pattern, structure, possibility. And from that belief, the world quietly shifted. Before machines learned anything, humans had to learn how to describe thinking itself. Mathematicians drew blueprints of logic, mapping ideas like explorers charting unknown seas. Claude Shannon, John von Neumann, Norbert Wiener minds, who saw intelligence not as mystery, but as design. Their work became the skeleton of modern computation. Quietly, they built a future they would never get to live in. In 1957, two young researchers attempted something audacious. They built a machine that tried to mimic a brain cell. It wasn't powerful, it could barely recognize shapes, but it carried something far greater than accuracy. It carried the promise that intelligence could be built, piece by piece. But progress does not follow passion, it follows reality. Expectations rose too quickly. Promises collapsed too loudly. Governments pulled funding. Public interest faded. And the dream froze under its own ambition. This era became known as the AI winter, a season when hope dimmed, but curiosity survived. And in the quiet, small breakthroughs continued like embers refusing to die. After decades of winter, something extraordinary happened. Computers became powerful enough to handle the dreams of the past. Data grew faster than thought, and neural networks finally had the fuel they needed. The algorithms didn't just improve, they evolved. For the first time, machines began to learn in ways that felt uncannily human. Then came a shift no one expected. Machines learned to understand language, context, emotion, and intent. GPT models didn't just generate text, they mirrored human expression. They wrote stories, explained ideas, composed emails, and held conversations that felt startlingly natural. The divide between human thought and machine response began to blur. AI didn't stay confined to screens. It moved into machines, into arms, wheels, sensors, and eyes. Robots began learning tasks the way children do, by repetition, trial, correction, and play. Factories transformed, logistics evolved, and for the first time, machines weren't just tools, they were teammates. In hospitals, AI became a second pair of eyes, sharper, faster, tireless. It detected tumors too small for human sight. It predicted risks before symptoms could speak. Doctors didn't lose their power. AI magnified it. Together, they saved lives that would have been lost to time. A new kind of creator has emerged. Someone who doesn't work alone, but works with intelligence. Where a full team was once required, now a single person with the right tools can build brands, products, and stories. AI became not a shortcut, but an amplifier. The age of the one-person creative revolution began quietly and spread like wildfire. For the first time in history, opportunity is no longer gated. No investors, no expensive software, no perfect resume. Anyone with curiosity can learn, build, and launch. AI leveled the playing field, not by making everyone equal, but by giving everyone a starting point. Entrepreneurs discovered something unexpected. AI wasn't just a tool, it was a silent partner. It drafted plans, ran numbers, predicted interest, and even shaped strategy. Small teams began to outperform giant corporations, not because they worked harder, but because they worked smarter. But the greatest shift wasn't economic, it was human. People rediscovered their hidden talents, passions, and abilities. AI didn't replace ambition, it reactivated it. A generation began asking a new question. What could I become if intelligence itself became my collaborator? The future of AI begins where we live. Imagine a home that senses stress in your voice and dims the lights. A kitchen that suggests meals based on your health, not your hunger. A bedroom that learns your sleep pattern and heals your fatigue before morning. Technology becomes invisible, yet deeply human. In tomorrow's classrooms, every student learns at their own speed. AI tutors adapt to curiosity, not curriculum. A child struggling in math receives patience. A child gifted in art receives challenge. For the first time, education bends to meet the student, not the other way around. AI won't just change how we work, it may redefine how long we live. Medical models discover patterns too small for any doctor to detect. New therapies emerge, personalized to each body, each gene. The future whispers a radical possibility: that life itself could be extended with precision, care, and dignity. AI may take us where human hands cannot go. Robots exploring distant moons, machines constructing habitats in space, and intelligent systems guiding humanity through darkness and vacuum. Space is no longer a dream. It becomes the frontier where human courage and machine precision unite. If the past asked, "Can machines think?" and the present asks, "What can machines do?" then the future asks something far more personal: what will we choose to become now that intelligence is shared? Because the greatest invention of the AI era will be us. The story of AI is not the story of machines. It is the story of human imagination, daring enough to ask impossible questions, patient enough to chase impossible dreams, and brave enough to share intelligence with something we created. The future is not waiting. It is being written by you. What if the next breakthrough in AI is not technology, but the person you decide to become? But even as we imagine the future, one truth remains unshaken. Intelligence alone does not define a species. Intention does. AI may extend our lifespans, build our homes, teach our children, but only we decide the purpose behind that power. Every invention in history came with a choice. Will we use it to rise or to retreat from ourselves? Tomorrow's world will not be defined by the machines we build, but by the wisdom we choose to cultivate. Empathy becomes a technology. Curiosity becomes a currency. And the courage to imagine becomes the foundation of progress. AI is not replacing us. It is revealing who we are capable of becoming. One day, we may look back at this moment and realize this was not the rise of artificial intelligence. This was the rise of augmented humanity, a future where our limitations shrink, but our responsibility expands, where the mind of a machine unlocks the heart of a person. And so the question remains, not what will AI become, but what will we choose to become alongside it? The horizon is wide, the tools are ready, and the next chapter of humanity is no longer written by chance, but by choice. The journey of AI is also the journey of our choices. Every line of code, every spark of invention, reflects not just possibility, but responsibility. What we build today shapes the humanity of tomorrow. If this journey inspired you, join us. Like, share, and subscribe to AI Past, Present, and Future, where we explore the ideas that shape tomorrow.